Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer News, where we share what's new to the Google Workspace platform. We have 10 topics to cover, so let's get started. You can now delete versions in your AppScript project from the project history page in the AppScript IDE. AppScript projects created after December 10th, 2023 can have up to 200 versions. You can permanently delete a version if it's not in use by an active deployment. To do so, click Project History, More Actions, Delete this version, delete. You can now get and update a user's read state in a Google chat space and get a user's read state in a message thread. User read states are singleton resources that represent details about a specified user's last read message. The users.spaces resource represents a user's read state in a space. The users.spaces.threads resource represents a user's read state in a message thread. User read states have been launched through the Developer Preview Program. The Google Meet Add-ons SDK is now available as part of the Developer Preview Program. The Meet Add-ons SDK lets you embed your app into Google Meet as an add-on, where users can discover, share, and collaborate in the app without leaving Meet. While in Developer Public Preview, add-ons can only be published for your own domain. Once the Meet Add-ons SDK is generally available, add-ons can be published publicly. If you want to start using the Meet Add-ons SDK, make sure to sign up for the Developer Preview Program. The Directory API now allows you to change the device status of Chrome OS devices in batch. Further, the action method of the Chrome OS devices resource is deprecated. Instead, use the batch change status method in the customer.devices.chromeOS resource. On screen, you see an example of how you can use the batch change status method to disable Chrome devices. To fix a bug that prevented events of event type not equal default from importing, we updated the code sample in Populate a Team Vacation Calendar, the popular AppScript and Calendar API solution. The Google Chat API spaces.list method now supports app authentication for query filters. This update enables you to filter by space type when you list spaces for your chat app. To learn more about authentication for chat apps, check out the video Understanding User and App Credentials in the Google Chat API, which you will find linked at the top right corner of this video right about now. To improve the developer experience when extending Google Workspace, we have added a comprehensive overview page to the developer documentation. The page describes your options for extending the Google Workspace user interface. You can now call version 3 of the Google Drive API from AppScript with the Advanced Drive service. This means that you can use the Advanced Drive service to perform tasks like list a user's shared drives, create new shared drives, app file properties, and so on. To get started using the Advanced Drive service, enable it in the AppScript IDE. The setPersistValues method has been added to the action class of the card service. This means that you can now indicate whether form values are determined by the client's values or the server's values after an action response updates a forms card. Let's see how persisting the client values helps prevent situations where a form changes unexpectedly after a user makes an edit. For example, a user notices a typo after submitting a form and edits the corresponding text input after submitting the form, but before the server responds. If the values are persisted, the edit the user made remains after the server response updates the card. Otherwise, the form value returns to the value that the user originally submitted to the form. We've published a comprehensive tutorial and code sample showing how to build the chat app using generative AI and a database. The chat app built in this tutorial uses Vertex AI to help write user stories and persist the stories in a Firestore database. We've added the link to the tutorial in the description for this video and invite you to try it out. Let us know in the comments section below, which new features are you most excited about trying out? Make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you stay up to date with all things Google Workspace platform related.